8 housemates and 4 halfway housemates. 1 crowd, 1 me, and 1 double eviction. Welcome to Big Brother. Wowzers! Woo! What a week it's been! Okay, so first things first. The death knell rang for Chiggy with the shock departure. Well, the departure of Chanel. But fear not, hanky-panky fans. Yeah, don't worry. Liam and Amy got it on! They could quite possibly be the new Chiggy, except they're Lamy. That's going to catch on, hasn't it? That's going to catch on, isn't it? Plus, we've got 5 new housemates. They moved into the halfway house. And from day one, it's been a throw your car keys into the fruit bowl kind of week. We're swapping going on here, there, everywhere. And now we've got David, Shanessa, Cara Louise and Tracy all in the halfway house, all facing eviction. Tonight, the 2 housemates with the most votes will be out on their ear and the 2 remaining ones will become official housemates once more. Okay, you have got the power to affect TV history, and that power lies in your trousers. Whip out your phone and get voting. To evict David, call 09011-212220. 09011-212220. Or to evict Cara Louise, call 09011-212222. 09011-212222. Or to evict Shanessa, call 09011-212223. 09011-212223. Or to evict Tracy, call 09011-212211. 09011-212211. Now at least 10 pence from each call is going to be donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother. Line's going to close at 19 minutes past 9. Okay, so right, let's get back to life on day 65. And David says, ta-da! To his lunch.
Dear 65, 12:43 p.m. Yesterday, Shanessa, Tracy, David and Cara Louise were chosen to go back into the halfway house by Amy, Liam, Jonty and Ziggy, who moved back into the main house. Both houses are aware that only halfway housemates will face a public vote this week. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Team Kiki, Team Corky, you seem very silly, you seem very, very hay-pitched.
I like his little waistcoat.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
None of your bears have got piercings or anything?
No.
Tattoos?
No, they're not really into that.
David and Cara Louise are in the dormitory talking about Amy.
Oh, I know what I saw on the TV screen, and she was so happy. Do you know what I mean? Not so happy. She doesn't have any problem with putting us all straight forward, which I find surprising.
Not even a second thought.
Yeah, there was no second thought. There was no I feel bad, like we all came in together.
It was bye now.
It was just like, yeah.
It's like, see ya, losers.
I know. She wasn't sorry on the TV screen. She had no problem with it.
Yeah, I didn't like certain of us.
So don't tell me sorry. Like, if you're going to make your decisions, fine. At least stand by them. Don't try slithering back when it's done.
Yeah.
I really
stand
hate
by
that.
Your convictions.
Yeah, exactly. Have a backbone and actually be like, well, do you know what? I made the decision.
I don't think it's fair Shanessa is back here so soon.
No.
Shanessa's there. I just feel she could have maybe spent her time over there.
Look, guys, we don't know who's going. It's not up to us. It's up to
the
public.
I know, but... I know, right?
You don't know?
I know, but I'm a fanny, do you know what I mean? I'm loud, I can be obnoxious, people
wouldn't... You don't know what the public see of you?
I know, but people wouldn't take well to me.
Well, you didn't expect them to call you back in here, did you? And I didn't expect to be in here.
I did, actually.
It will be.
Just
I can't worry.
Do you know what I'd really hate, though, for somebody like her to win it now?
To say? Hate's a strong word, man.
No, I don't hate her. I'd hate for somebody like her to win.
There's only one of her, isn't there?
There is, aye.
PM. Halfway housemates Tracy and Shanessa are in the dormitory.
Well, they'll be voting today.
Will they?
Tonight.
For what they've seen of everything and that. Today, tonight and tomorrow, probably.
I can't really mind, man, if I leave here tomorrow night. I can't. So I've had such a long, you know what I mean, long space of time. It's a bit different for you guys, because you've... Do you know what I mean?
Would you say you were ready to go?
I'm never ready. Nah.
Ziggy and Liam are in the garden.
Can't say how good it is to be back here.
It's
liberating, isn't it?
It's enough to really, like, for it to go in there was completely worth it.
Mm.
It's like you feel like $1 million. You feel like you're a bit reborn in here, don't you?
Yeah, you definitely. We feel like you're new again.
Aye.
Yeah, like reborn, yeah.
Carol and Jonty are in the living area.
I think it's going to be difficult from today onwards for the public to vote someone out over there. I don't believe that Tracy will go, and on that basis, somebody else that I like is going to.
So, what one of the new people is?
Will probably leave, if not two.
Yeah.
I'd be very shocked if the public voted Tracy out, because our understanding is she's one of the favourites to win.
Right. That would be good, actually, wouldn't it? Somebody who's been a cleaner and that suddenly. Going on to win Big Brother, that would be cool.
Brian, Amy and Amanda are in the caravan talking about the new housemates.
It's just really weird, it's adding a new dimension to it.
Yeah.
It feels so much more comfortable. Last night was so nice. Obviously, after spending the night where you felt like bloody hell, you didn't feel at home, and then spending last night, it was like bloody hell.
Having everyone back.
Felt like the most, would you admit, man, it felt like the most like home this place has ever felt like.
Oh, bless you.
It felt really good last night.
I was happy, but I felt really bad about next door.
You could almost smell that there was tension in the air for everything, for both houses.
Yeah.
Sort of thing.
And obviously, like, you lot were really pleased to see Liam and Ziggy, but then you were all, like, gathering on, and I just literally stood by myself.
So it's like you're really happy to be a housemate, but you still don't know.
No, I was still, like, complete outsider. Yeah. And I was just like,
But it's the social standing inside here that's different.
Yeah, exactly.
It's not like you're going into Big Brother, it's like you've just moved into someone's flat.
Yeah, it's just moving into a group of mates.
Yeah.
It's like going to a new school, isn't
it? Yeah, literally like that. At least you're in, we've lived with you for one night, at least we know now you're not a sketchy housemate.
PM. Big Brother has gathered all the housemates on the sofas.
First proper bad kiss I had was the last... Oh, I can't even say her name, because it's part of her for real. But I felt her teeth down the side of her foot and down the side of my mouth.
Well, my one, that's racist.
That was her first kiss, you know. That was quite... You know, she'd kiss late on, really. She was getting... I was getting... Wow! There, that was lovely.
I got on with someone, like, a few months ago that, like, everything was great. Till he kissed me, and then he seemed to feel the need to actually bite the whole of my face off. And within seconds, I was like, yeah, couldn't be less turned on.
Yeah, why are you doing that?
But then it was kind of too late, because I was stuck back at his hole. But he still thought he was a complete stud, and I was like, no, because it doesn't work.
For this week's Shop and Task, halfway housemates have the chance to win a luxury shopping budget for housemates. Halfway housemates will be called to the diary room and asked to consume food prepared by Big Brother. Each halfway housemate has the opportunity to win £100 towards the housemate's luxury shopping budget. David is the first halfway housemate to be called to the diary room.
Oh, look, there's David sitting in the chair.
Hello, David.
Bring it on.
Scotland!
Yoni! Go, David!
David, please lift up the silver cloche. Or... is it raw meat?
He won't eat raw meat.
Your luxury food item is a plate...